Hey, this is Anthony Cesari with successtoyoursongs.com, and in this video, we're going to take a look at how Olivia Rodrigo uses a cool little poetic line break at the beginning of one of her songs so that you can use a similar approach in your music when you're writing your lyrics. Okay, so the Olivia Rodrigo song that I want to talk about here is called Brutal, and I want to talk about line breaks. Because generally speaking, when you're writing a song, you want your melodic lines to line up with your lyrical lines. That's how a line makes sense. We could just look at an example in this song so you can see what I'm talking about. So like, let's look at the third and fourth lines of the song. And I'm so caught up in the news of who likes me and who hates you. So two separate lines lyrically, and you can also hear those are two separate lines melodically as well.
Drink, and I'm so caught up in the news of who likes me and who hates you.
So again, you can hear that's clearly two separate lines melodically and lyrically as well. So that's generally what you want to go for, because if that line would have been, and I'm so caught up in the news of who, lyrically, and that all ended up on one line of melody, and then the next line broke at the lyric and said, likes me and who hates you, that would feel awkward, because you would have a line that wants to end somewhere else on the melody, and then it doesn't, and it just doesn't feel conversational. So generally, we strive for lyrical and melodic lines lining up. Sometimes, though, you can break that rule, and it ends up being more poetic. And that's what happens in the first couple of lines in this song. So those lines are, I'm so insecure, I think, that I'll die before I drink. Before we move on, I just want to mention that we have a couple of free songwriting cheat sheets for you that can download in the upper right-hand side of the screen. You can just tap that little eye and grab those. Also, if you have not yet subscribed to this YouTube channel to stay updated on our latest songwriting videos, we've got a subscribe button on the lower right-hand side of the video. You can do that there. So this here is one melodic line. And then this is a second melodic line. But you can read this second line as starting from here. I think that I'll die before I drink. So it reads as a broken line. But the reason that's okay in this specific instance is because it also applies to the first line. So I'm so insecure, I think, would be something that someone who's insecure would say. Like, I'm so insecure, at least I think I am. There's like insecurity built into that line. So then this phrase, I think, ends up really pertaining to both lines. It works for this first line to complete that initial thought, but it also dips into that second line as well. It would be different, let's say, if it was, I'm so insecure, I think, and I'll die before I drink, because then this wouldn't be a complete sentence. It wouldn't be, I think, and I'll die before I drink. Then that would be two separate thoughts. So it makes this a move similar to something that you might do in a poem with a line breaking in a specific spot to make a point, is the fact that, you know, it starts on this word that. So it's you know that it's continuing from the line before. So I think that I'll die before I drink, but also that I think can be tied back to this insecure idea as well. So it sort of has it both ways. It actually, it does complete the thought, but then it also breaks the line so that I think can do double duty. So if you are going to have your melody not match up with your lyrics, you want to do it in a way like this that's thought out and intentional, as opposed to just fitting words where they fit in your melody, and then that sounds weird when you're hearing the song sung back. So let's hear that in this song.
I'm so insecure, I think, that I'll die before I drink.
So that's the way to do that. I've actually used a similar technique in one of my songs. It's called The Charming Little Act, and it happens in the bridge. So this song's about how the small little things that someone does in a relationship can have the biggest impact on the other person. So the bridge is here. All these gifts, they arrive so small, but they have a pull, and I collect them all for a gravity that makes me fall in love. So for the most part, these lyrical lines all line up with their melodic lines, and I'll play that for you so you can hear it, except for on this last couple of lines here that make me fall, and then there's a pause in love. So normally that could come off as awkward, but since it's being led into with the line for a gravity, then the implication is the gravity is the thing that makes me fall. And then by adding on in love after that, it gives it additional meaning there. So this is another example of an intentional use of a line break where the lyrical line actually extends past into two melodic lines, but it's done in a way that has meaning. But let's take a listen to that one so you can see if you think that works. So again, similar idea there, just showing you this so that you can start to figure out ways that if you are going to break your lines when you're writing songs, that you do it in a way that's intentional and supports the meaning of the lyric. So hopefully that'll give you a new concept to use here. So I hope you found that information useful. If you'd like a lot more ways to improve your songwriting, I've got a couple of free cheat sheets for you that you can download by tapping on the screen here. Also, if you have not yet subscribed to this YouTube channel to stay updated on our latest songwriting videos, you can tap our logo on the screen for that. And there's also a link on this screen where you can hear the song that I played for you in this video and the song that you're hearing right now. So thank you for checking this one out. I'll talk to you in the next one.